scavenged them all, looking for anything I could find on G Corporation's Kazuya, including his historical and familial links to the Mishima Zaibatsu. The truth had to be revealed, even if it meant doing so alone. The Mishimas were warriors hailing back as far as the Taira and Minamoto eras. With the advent of World War, they capitalized on the increased military demand. During my research, I came across two significant names. The first was Jinpachi Mishima. Head of the Mishima clan during the war, he abhorred Iba's conflict and reacted accordingly against the organization's military expansion by resolving instead to devote his family's legacy solely to martial arts. However, all that changed when Heihachi wrested control of the family helm, proceeding to rename the organization Mishima Zaibatsu.
Tasty of the Mishima family, huh?
Heihachi secured its reputation as a world-leading military firm. Which brings us to the second name, Jin Kazama. Seizing control from Heihachi, he reigned over his empire until only recently. He was also the one who started this damn war, which took everything from me. I dreamed of one day killing him.
The Mishimas.
Jin-kaza. So che il suo demone interiore supera perfino quello di Kazuya. Un momento. Chi fosse lui?
Do you know something?
Ci hanno riferito che un essere disumano è apparso in Estremo
Oriente.
So that means Jin is.
Okay, remember in Tekken 6 when Raven had found Jin? It's Raven. Yep.
Everything looks clear. En route to the United Nations HQ.
Roger that.
What?
The question is now, where's Raven? Is he dead or or just out stranded somewhere? Did he teleport out the helicopter or not? I guess we'll find out in Tekken 8. There's Jin. And here comes Lars. I really wish Eddie had a role in this, in the main story.
Oh,
She's like playing Time Crisis, Crisis Zone.
Is that Lars?
Things
just got a whole lot more complicated.
In case you don't know who Lars is, Lars is
stay one step ahead.
One of Heihachi's sons, okay? So Heihachi has three sons. He has Kazuya, he has Lars, and he has his adopted one, Lee Chao-Nan. So. Akuma.
This lead sent me on a journey through countless documents, where I finally found her name in a single paragraph, Kazumi Hachijo. There was no mention of what kind of life she and Heihachi had led together, but it confirmed that Heihachi was Kazuya's father and Kazumi his mother. That's when I realized something shocking. The year Heihachi seized control from Jinpachi and established the Zaimatsu was the same year his wife Kazumi had died, and Kazuya had fallen from a cliff, sustaining terrible injuries. What could all this mean?
Kazuya.
Have a handle on Heihachi Mishima's movements. It appears he's conducting a thorough search for Jin Kazama.
Jin wo tsukau ki ka. Sakusen no junbi wo isogaseru.
Frustration. Eventually, I ran into a guy in a restaurant. His eyes burned with an almost ungodly fighting spirit. And he looked at me as though he could see the darkest depths of my soul.
It's Lee Chao-Nan.
So, you're the one who's been looking at
my favorite Mishima.
He said before making his way to the exit. The way he stared at me from the door let me know that he wanted me to follow him. Hypnotized, I walked slowly towards him.
As Lee Chao-Nan
formally introduced himself. His name was Lee Chao-Nan.
That's creepy as hell.
All
right. Time for Lee to spring to action. Yeah, when I was really into the Mishimas, Lee was my prime main. And yes, Bruce was a mate of mine back then, you know. It wasn't until like 2012, when Bruce became my prime main, you know. When I start, you know, getting more into the non-Mishima characters. So, but once again, Bruce has always been one of my favorite characters. He's always been like, yeah. So. Him and Eddie, actually, yeah. Backup girl. Excellent. But make no mistake, Bruce is my number one main character. My prime main, so. Tekken 6. She called him creepy. Yeah, he was looking creepy in Tekken 6, though. I ain't gonna lie about that.
I already knew about Li Chao-Lan's happening. Violent systems. Famous for its humanoid research and brilliance in the field of ergonomics. As a child, Li had been adopted by Heihachi Mishima. So he knew Kazuya G-Corp and once shared a rivalry with him. I listened intently, excited about this new breakthrough. Lee's knowledge went beyond that of any article I had written. What he said next, though, unsettled me. He continued.
So since we're talking about G Corporation, I'm wondering where the hell is Bruce at? Since he's like the head of the G Corporation forces, you know?
Ha! もう大丈夫だ。こちらは任せてくれたまえ。
はい。
All right, Yu Chao Lan.For me, Lee was the easiest character to learn when I first started playing Tekken 2. This was, of course, the first move that I really started learning with him, this right here.And then when I started using Bruce,back in the, when I started practicing with him in Tekken Tag Tournament 1, that's when I learned his Bruce Ryuken and stuff, because I always wanted to know how to do that move. I tried him out in the arcade in Tekken 2 prior, but I didn't really know how to use him. I was like, okay, I need to, he's a character I need to practice with, but I mean, yeah. But, back up, Tekken Force, huh? Next, Sugi. Silver Cyclone. Okay. Silver Cyclone. Come on.